7 years into the Lebanese civil war, and after years of Lebanon being used as a springboard for Palestinian attacks against Israel, there was growing criticism over the Palestinian Liberation Organization's continued presence in Israel's northern neighbor. On June 6, 1982, after incessant rocket attacks, Israel invaded Lebanon, ostensibly to push the PLO back 40 kilometers and remove northern Israel from being within Palestinian rocket range.
I know that the Israelis, they want to continue this conspiracy against the Lebanese people, against this, against our Palestinians, to continue in this genocide, in this massacres.
But Israeli troops kept going beyond 40 kilometers, and by August 30th, much of the capital city of the country, once dubbed the Switzerland of the Middle East, was reduced to rubble.
The suffering was very bad among the Lebanese society. Beirut was destroyed, especially West Beirut. West Beirut, for 2 months, was outside of water, food. It was a humanitarian catastrophe.
As the fighting intensified and international pressure mounted, the PLO leadership was forced to leave Lebanon in search of new headquarters.
There was pressure by local civil forces, as well as some Arab forces, which led to the understanding by the PLO that the only way to stop the fighting was to move its base of operations from one Arab area to another, be it Tunisia or Jordan or elsewhere.
On the last Monday of August, thousands of PLO fighters, leaders, and their families left Beirut and boarded a ship to Greece, and from there to Tunisia, much to the disappointment of those left behind.
And I think the PLO was trying to save as much as possible, or avoid as much as possible more suffering among Lebanese civilians. That was the main reason.
Despite the blow of losing the war, relocating its headquarters proved to have some positive effects for the PLO in the long run.
The PLO emerged stronger than before, as it enjoyed a warm and true embrace of Arab and Muslim countries, as well as increased support by the Palestinian people.
The war in Lebanon gave the PLO legitimacy among Arab states, who began increasing their financial support to it. It also strengthened the status of Yasser Arafat in the Arab world and solidified the PLO's status as the official representative of the Palestinian people. And, difficult as it was to foresee at the time, it set the stage for peace negotiations between Israel and the Palestinians a decade later.
I think evacuating the PLO from Lebanon was a positive move, and whether the Palestinian leadership planned for it or not, but it led to a very important political progress that also occurred.
But peace negotiations between Israel and the Palestinians never reached fruition. The years that followed saw bloody violence and terror attacks, which, along with Israeli settlement expansion, prevented the continued implementation of the Oslo Accords. Since then, the PLO's standing among Palestinians, as well as other Arab nations, has all but crumbled. And yet, many Palestinians see that day in August of 1982 as a turning point in promoting the Palestinian cause for statehood, with Jerusalem as its capital. A struggle that continues to this day.
As he was leaving Beirut, Arafat was asked where he would go. And he said, "I'm going to Jerusalem." And in fact, a decade later, he reached the outskirts of Jerusalem. Now, we as Palestinians are completing the path of Arafat.